It's too cold. I'm sure it's really cold where you are too. Weather, climate change, okay. Whatever is causing it. Fact is, it's getting more extreme, right? Notice the correlation between weather and humans. As a friend said in a recent video on YouTube, existence is cyclocentric. Okay, very nice word. And it's true. We humans are also all enmeshed in all these cycles with all of nature. Okay. As the weather becomes more extreme, more polarized, hotter, colder, severe deluges, etc., humanity actually becomes the same way. We are now incredibly polarized, extremists on both sides, right? And also look for severe social storms to start taking place, as the Arab Spring, for instance, was one of those, as these huge tsunamis, as these gigantic typhoons and hurricanes, etc., decimate, you know, from the weather. Keep in mind that humanity and the weather are tied together, actually, very much so. And expect severe, heavy-handed actions in the world very soon. I had a dream that, again, I had fled down south, and up north there was this incredibly heavy rain, all right? Heavy-handed rain of heavy-handedness. It's coming. I mean, this Obamacare thing is such an example of an extreme storm, okay? A social storm. It's not a joke. So we are cyclocentric. We are all bought the human situation, which is not what we are at all, actually. We're spirit. And humanity has absolutely nothing to do with reality or what we are whatsoever. I pointed this out in every single video. But all of neither does nature. All of nature, all of this is all one dynamic. So expect radicalism, expect, you know, extremism, and expect the, you know, mudslides, you know, the deluges of rain coming down so heavy that, look at the flooding in the Himalayas, the flooding in Pakistan, the flooding all over the planet. There's this incredible flooding where, like, in a span of an hour or two, you know, so much rain comes down, it just blows the bridges out and just floods everything. Same thing socially. Expect social situations to arise that are so severe, so crippling, it just wipes stuff out, and it is coming, and it is happening. This Affordable Care Act is just one example, but actually there's many such examples of devastating rapid erosion of the Constitution, of safeguards of freedom, safeguards of freedom of speech, freedom of religion, all this stuff, okay, is getting devastated. All part of the cyclocentric activity of this play of existence, which we have thoroughly vetted over and over and over again. Now, the important thing is to not get caught up in the intrigue over this. Everyone is vulnerable to that. I am vulnerable. I struggle with it constantly. Don't try to see how it turns out, because everybody's bragging. It's like a baseball team. It's like the Yankees, you know, bragging about, we got it won on paper. Or the Dodgers say, oh yeah, we got the World Series won. Look on paper, we got it won. Well, don't stick around to see how it turns out. It doesn't really matter. Let people brag. And society is saying, we got a utopia coming, folks. Everybody's going to have free health care. I mean, imagine, just remember how the health care, Affordable Care Act was sold. It basically was telling people who were not too bright, saying, everybody's going to have free health care. It's free health care. Yeah, you're going to have free health care. And then they said, well, maybe just real minimal payment. You know, it's just, you know, it's going to be great. We got this utopia. Cradle to grave health care. No more worries, folks. We got it all worked out. Now see how things are. This is just one example. So the intrigue to find out how terrible is it does it turn out? It's like saying, I want to watch the baseball season just to see the Yankees implode or something, you know. They think, you know, the high and mighty say, oh, we got it won. How do things fall apart for them, you know? That's the intrigue, the doom. We say, how does the doom really come about? I want to see. The greatest thing you can do is to say, no, I don't need to see how anything turns out, because it really has nothing to do with anything. And that is a fact. Existence is really nothing. It has nothing to do with anything. it's just this ephemeral appearance like clouds. And there's no relevance to it or meaning whatsoever. So how does it turn out? It doesn't turn out any way at all, is the actual answer to it all. It just keeps, like clouds, they just, you know, they keep showing up and do a little dance and fade away. There is no conclusion, result to existence. There isn't any. So we have to have enough wisdom just to tilt a certain direction. Which way do we tilt? There's certainly a lot of intrigue in all of us. So let's admit that. Let's admit, yes, I am intrigued by how is it going to turn out. But have enough weight on the other side to say, but I'm not that intrigued to get caught up in it. I don't really want to see how it turns out, because it doesn't turn out. It just keeps going. It just keeps going. There is no conclusion to a dream except for ultimately awakening from the dream. That's the conclusion. But as far as what's happening in a dream, there is no conclusion. How can there be? How can there be a conclusion to trying to remember what never happened? Existence is really like an attempt to for us to try and remember, how did we get to be prime creator? Yeah, how do we do that? Because we think we've forgotten. We think we've forgotten something really important. And we're trying to, and that we fell from grace, and we're trying to remember, how did we, you know, how did we get there? Yeah, we used to be prime creator. Now, how do we manage that? So we concoct this, all these cycles of death and impermanence, this dance of clouds. And we're trying to remind ourselves how we did it. We never did it. We never did it. We never fell from grace. We never were prime creator. And so there's no memory of how we did it. So we're trying to remember a memory which doesn't exist. So what kind of conclusion that can there be to this, except to realize that we don't need it? Now, that is the conclusion. The conclusion is we don't need a conclusion. And this is a very nice, concise way, something you can put in your back pocket, like a wallet, or in your purse, and just say, hey, the conclusion is we don't need a conclusion. So when the intrigue grabs you, you say, I already know the conclusion, because I don't need a conclusion. There isn't any conclusion, I don't need one, because there is nothing to remember, so we don't need a conclusion. The conclusion is all wrapped up in the notion that we will remember how we became prime creator, and then that will be the conclusion. We'll finally remember it. There is no such memory there. We never were, so there isn't any conclusion to existence, except to say, we don't need any conclusion. So the path is really about getting to that point, saying, I don't need any conclusion to existence. I don't need any conclusion. And then you'll be able to see it as the ephemeral, you know, cloud-like appearance in pure spaciousness. You'll be able to see that, eventually be able to recognize that once you realize you don't need any conclusion to it. Otherwise, you're going to reify it, which means to concretize something abstract. Like we look at everything, like the trees, the plants, the ground, everything, and we think it's stable, it's a thing. It's not. It's just slow motion clouds. Everything is, the stuff we think is solid is just clouds in slow motion. If you look at the clouds in the sky, they seem to be, you know, a little quicker motion. But even those are, they're drifting slowly. We look up and we think they're things, they're pretty stationary. But if you take a camera, which I have been doing recently, and maybe I'll attach some of this video to the end of this video so you're able to look at this. The clouds are engaged in this incredible ephemeral dance in the, every day in the sky. And it's just amazing how they disappear and suddenly grow, and it's just like, wow, they're totally ephemeral, really, if you put it in fast motion. Well, imagine if you took a time-lapse photography of everything in the world. You know, what one frame a day, one frame every 10 days for trees or something, you know, and just everything, and you looked at it and you ran back the video, you'd see it's all like a dance of clouds. It's all like a dance of clouds. Everything is entirely ephemeral here. But we don't recognize that because of our desire for a conclusion. And if we saw the nature of nature, you'd say that there's nothing really going on here. How could there be a conclusion to this? It's all just this ephemeralness taking place in pure spaciousness, and we'd recognize, this is just a whim. It's just a whim on our part. Now, this issue of existence being a whim is central to what I'm sharing, very central. Because you cannot reason with whim. And you might say whim is the ego. Okay, what is whim? Whim is the notion that we can be prime creator. That's a whim. And whim, what whim does is it cannot recognize its whim, because that would be logical, be reasonable, right? So the very nature of whim is to deny that it's whim. And this denying that it's whim takes the form of marketing and advertising campaign. In actuality, the whole cosmos, the whole nature, all of this whim is a marketing campaign. That's all that it really is. Mind is marketing whim to spirit. That is what existence is really all about. It's also trying to teach us how to die to what we are. It's also trying to teach us how to remember how we got to be prime creator. It's all kind of wrapped up in this big marketing strategy that whim is employing, pretending that this is not whim, is existence. Existence is the pretense that it's not whim. It's something else. Now, we don't know what else. That's why we think existence is such a mystery, and we have to reify it in all sorts of ways, of hierarchies and you know, levels and evolution. That's all just a total reification. It's a mystery to us because we're not willing to see that it's a whim. We say it must be, it's something else. It's not whim, it's something else. Well, what is it? What is it? And we knock ourselves out forever and a day trying to figure out what is existence when in fact it's just a whim. So this marketing strategy that whim must engage in, it must engage in it to extend itself at all. And see, creation is about extension. So naturally, mind automatically extends whim. But how does mind extend whim, except for this marketing campaign that says it's not what it is, it's something else. It's not what it is, it's something else. So obviously we have a continuity problem. The only problem that whim brings is a continuity problem, because we're totally used now to saying that what is isn't what it is, it's something else. So we're afraid of reality, we're afraid of seeing everything exactly as it is and not as something else. We're afraid of that abruptness. So we have a continuity problem with whim. Big time, huge continuity problem. So we admit, yes, this is all just whim. Yes, I have a huge continuity problem. Yes, I'm looking at what the solution is for that continuity problem. These are the fundamentals of what I'm sharing. Now this is different than other teaching, I'm aware of that. Quite different, that's okay. I feel very comfortable with this. It's, for me, it's spot on. When we get up in the morning and say, I have a continuity problem. God, I have a continuity problem. That's the only problem I have. I've been following whim. This marketing campaign. Now, this marketing campaign of whim is ferocious. It is so ferocious. It is so overwhelming. And yet, without the continuity problem, we would be able to see through it. Guaranteed. I've been able to see through it, but it keeps coming back on me because of the continuity issue. That's the only reason. We have the capacity to dismiss this marketing program. but it is quite clever. The mind is very, very clever in how it does this. And so if you feel like trapped, if you feel like it's so difficult, ultimately it's the continuity problem. That is what is giving you all this trouble. Without the continuity issue, you would not feel so trapped. You'd be able to just cut through like a knife, hot knife through butter. Man, it's getting very windy here. Last weekend, it was 75 degrees. Wow. And now, it's like snow in the mountains. It was down to 26 degrees. And it's like Arctic. Holy cow. This is really something. Trying to keep the plants alive. So far, taking some heroic measures to do so. And so far, things seem to have survived. So, don't be overly concerned about feeling trapped. Go back and say, I have a continuity problem. Keep centering on that. Because the marketing campaign of the quote-unquote ego, which is the mind in the service of this whim, marketing whim to us, is ingenious and so clever and so ingenious. Don't waste your time trying to track all that stuff down. We're trying to save time here. Cold. Save time. Continuity problem. The intrigue of how it turns out. We don't need a conclusion. So it doesn't, we're not looking for any conclusion to it. We're just looking for the resolution to the continuity problem. That's all we're looking for. And I've seen the basics of that. Okay, so there is something there. There is a resolution to this continuity problem. And it's not necessarily the highest, seeing everything as just pure spaciousness. That's the ultimate. That's beyond the resolution of the continuity problem. That's what happens when the continuity problem is resolved. But first, we need the resolution of the continuity problem. And that certainly doesn't come from seeing conclusions in existence, except for a hallucinated conclusion, as it were. All of this existence is a hallucination, actually. So any conclusion will also be hallucination. So since there is no conclusion at all as far as existence reaching its goal, what we can do is hallucinate a conclusion to it. Now people will say, hey, you're not going to find out what the real conclusion is. No, there is no conclusion. So even this resolution of the continuity problem is not a conclusion. It's not a real conclusion to it. It's resolving the continuity problem to the point where we can accept that there never will be a conclusion to existence, and because why? We don't need it. We don't need it at all. We don't need any of it. We don't need to find out how we got to be prime creator, because we're not, right? So we don't need that information, because it's completely meaningless information. How did we get to be prime creator? We didn't. So we don't need it. But to get to the point where we can say we don't need this, okay, We need to hallucinate a conclusion, as it were. So, of course, mind and whim will scream and say, you know, you're crazy, you can't do that. You're going to go off on some tangent, etc. You know, you're not following the flow of nature. You're not following this great grand plan that God has, and how this evolution, that process, how we're evolving, and, you know, you're not following that. You're jumping ship, and blah, 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 blah. Absolutely jump ship. Jump the ship that is perpetually sinking, okay? Jump the ship that is perpetually sinking into its utter uselessness. Existence is utterly useless, and because of the continuity problem, we're terrified of that fact. So you better find a use for it, which is to hallucinate a conclusion to it. Mind can do that. Holy Spirit directs mind to do that. Hallucinate a conclusion for this reification, this crazy dance of reification. this crazy dance of nothingness, pretending to be a memory, you know, this pretense that we're getting to a memory, that we're evolving towards a spaciousness. So let us keep getting back to the basics, okay? Let us keep getting back to the basics. That is where you will find your centeredness. And you do need to stay centered at this time. Now, here's some advice. Keep cultivating all your good habits, all right? As many as you can. That is super important right now. Don't let go of those good habits. Be the best that you can be. It's just as far as habits go right now. Put your emphasis on maintaining your good habits, which I am trying to do along with everybody else. I'm still falling prey to a few bad habits, but minimizing them. Minimize them, minimize them. Of course, at this time, you will be pulled into a few bad habits probably. Right. That's just, it's like golf. You're going to have a few bogeys, okay? Minimize the bogeys. Minimize the bad shots. So if you realize that you're you know, starting to get sidetracked, they say, okay, that's enough of that. Get back to this. Like before this taping, I was getting sidetracked on the internet. I said, no, let's tape. So that's good. Maintain just fundamental, basic, solid, good habits. Watch your health. Watch all of that. Don't let it all go to seed right now. Keep yourself intact, because it's a time now where the ship is sinking. Okay, the ship is sinking. Throw away the oars that are pulling you down. Abandon the ship. Abandon the ship. It's sinking. Along with this extreme weather, it's going to get more and more extreme. Events in this world are going to get more and more extreme. We are going to have very, very, very cold, devastating social situation in the world coming up. We already have it, but it's going to get way, way worse. So maintain your good habits and then get back to the basics. That's what I'm here for, is to help your attention get to the basics. That's where the answer is. So we don't need any conclusion. Therefore, we can accept a quote-unquote hallucinated conclusion to exit the reification that exists, all this so-called concretization that we think that we're, you know, existing in some place or something that is somehow, no, this memory of all this stuff is ephemeral. There's nothing really here. There's no real memory at all taking place. So hallucinate a conclusion to existence. So along these lines, you may find yourself going towards much, much better situations. Those people who are hanging in with the world, they are hardcore saying, no matter how bad it gets, we're going to stick it out because we want to find out what the conclusion is. This is delusion. Okay, I have to say, this is severe delusion. And unfortunately, most people are severely deluded, and they think they need to stick it out for some conclusion. And it's very powerful in us, like this feeling like, no, I need a conclusion. But again, existence itself cannot give you a conclusion, because its purpose is to remember something that never happened. So there is no conclusion. So we have to choose a different idea. We have to decide in our will, hey, I want to drop this stupidity, this whim. I want to drop whimsicality. Therefore, we need, because of the continuity issue, we need a conclusion to existence. Since there is none, we have to hallucinate one. We have to just imagine a conclusion. And that's what the Holy Spirit is for. It gives us an imagined conclusion to existence. Just as valid as the imagining of existence, right? But it's pragmatic. It's pragmatic. Whereas existence is totally unpragmatic, totally whimsical. So how do you solve whimsicality? Through pragmatism, actually. Whimsicality cannot understand anything. It's pretending to be something that it isn't. So it pretends that it can understand everything. It understands nothing. It pretends it's very pragmatic. It has no pragmatism to it whatsoever. It simply keeps marketing, that there is some conclusion, that we can find this memory. We can learn how to die. We can find the memory of how we got to be Prime Creator through dying to what we were and being resurrected as Prime Creator. All absolute fantasy whimsicality. So pragmatism has to come to the rescue. The Holy Spirit is profoundly pragmatic, perfectly pragmatic. So keep your good habits going, whatever they may be in your life. I mean, I have a whole list of stuff that I don't do. For instance, I try not to listen to radio at all. Try not to look at the news at all. Try not to watch television at all. Stay on a strict, strict diet, which I'm doing. I've dropped 14 pounds in just a little over a month. 14 pounds in just a little over a month. Okay? That's pretty good. I've been averaging almost a half a pound per day at weight loss. And I'm almost at my target. I'm almost close to hitting my target for this time. This weekend, I should hit my target, and then I'll go a little lower. So stay, you know, have like good habits and a goal right now that's just keeping me focused. And exercising more, moving around much better, sleeping better, just all sorts of good habits are going on right now. And that's what you need right now. You need to emphasize your good habits. Whatever they may be, you can just make a list of what habits are you working on. You should have like about 10 of them, something like that. 5 to 10, just come up with at least 5 really good habits that you is very important for you. One of them may be just normalcy. Just keeping the flow of your life. Just keep on grinding away. Just take care of, you know, just be, don't try to be some way out situation. Just stay within the context of your life right now. So that could be one of them. So stay with it, stay with the basics. I'll try to keep pulling everyone back to the basics. Because that is where the answer is. That is where the answer is. Literally, we have to accept a hallucination, an hallucinated ending, conclusion to existence. It's like we're watching a movie, and it goes on and on and on and on and on. And finally, we say, "Hey, where's the end of the movie?" There isn't any. So we have to imagine the end of the movie. Imagine we just splice in an ending to the movie, and there it is. But whereas other people are still seeing the same movie, so it's almost like, let's say we have a tablet. Okay, we're in a movie theater, and we have our tablet, our smartphone or something, and there's a movie going on. It's going on and on and on. We're getting so hungry and tired, we want to go home. But we say, "I need the ending, I need the ending." And so then we look at our tablet instead of the movie screen. And on the tablet, there's this beautiful ending to the movie. And we watch it and we say, "Ah, that's absolutely wonderful." And then so we get up and leave the theater, whereas everybody else is still watching the movie. And they're still saying, "Where's the ending? Where's the ending? I don't see any ending." You've already seen this beautiful ending, which satisfies you. And you say, "Oh, it satisfies me. I don't need to see anything more in the movie." Okay? So it's like that. This tablet, we're watching a beautiful, beautiful ending to the movie. Okay? So that is what I'm talking about right now. Maybe I'll post some videos. I got a bad dream last night trying to tell me not to. I don't know if I should or not, but we need to start seeing a beautiful ending to all of this right now. A beautiful ending, a wonderful ending. We have to get in that mode and off the mode of the world. I've always said we need to follow a new news story. But look at this image of a tablet. Okay, you've got your tablet or smartphone, and you are watching a beautiful ending to the movie you've been watching. You're not watching the screen anymore. You're watching this tablet, and you are satisfied. You say, "Okay, fine, done." You see? Got it done. That's where we're at right now. That's where we're at. So I've been employing all sorts of stuff on the video, but I haven't posted it. You know, I'm like, should I do it? Maybe. It's been so darn cold. I've been just working inside. You know, it's, and this is probably enough out here, or else I'm going to freeze. So everybody else, stay warm out there. Stay warm wherever you are. Stay with your good habits. Yeah, stay focused and hopefully keep watching these videos, because I'm not done. I'm still focused, more focused than ever here. You know, it's not easy, but stick with your habits and you'll still have the juice, okay, to keep going here. And we'll get this beautiful ending to existence. We'll get it right now. We're not going to go through a 4D cycle, okay? That's watching the movie. That's continuing to watch the movie. 4D is just the next part four of the movie. We've had part one, part two, part three. Now here's part four of the movie. And this gets you to part five of the movie. No, you just end up watching the movie on and on and on and on and on and on and on. Forget it. You don't need that. You can see a beautiful ending to the movie right now. All right. Very great. Let's get to that ending right now. That's it.